Morning, children, and welcome back to the English class. Children, today we are going to start lesson number 10, that is a gift of love, Eid. Children, before we start the chapter, let me tell you, this is the story of a 4-year-old boy, Hamid. On Eid, all his friends enjoy themselves by buying toys, eating sweets and playing games in the fair. But Hamid saves his money to buy something different. That is, we are going to find out in this chapter what different he has bought. So first of all, let us know something about the author. This beautiful chapter is written by Munshi Premchand. He was an Indian writer. He is best known for his novels like Godaan, Gabban and Karma Bhoomi. His works often depict the problems of the poor and throw light on social issues of his time, such as poverty, feudal system, corruption and India's freedom movement. He is widely regarded as Upanyas Samrat, which means emperor among novelists. So now moving to the chapter, all of you open page number 76 and put your fingers where I'm reading. So I'm reading the first para. It is Eid. The boys have been waiting to go to the Eidgah. The happiest of them is Hamid. He is only 4, poorly dressed, thin and weak. His father died last year of cholera and his mother died soon after. Now Hamid lives with his grandmother Amina. She tells him that his father had gone to earn money and will return with sack loads of silver, and that his mother has gone to Allah to get lovely gifts for him. This makes Hamid very happy. So before we start it, let's see the word meanings. The very first one is Eidgah. It's an open air enclosure where Eid prayers are offered. The next we have is cholera. It is an infectious disease that affects the stomach and intestines. Next word we have suburbs. It is a residential area near a town or city but away from its center. Tongas and ekas. These are horse-drawn vehicles. And the last one is rustics. Means so unsophisticated villagers. Now children, see the paragraph again. It's the day of Eid. And all the boys of the village, as you can see in the picture, they are waiting. They are very excited to go to the Eidgah. The happiest one is Hamid. So in this paragraph, it is being told that he's only 4 years. He is poorly dressed. He is thin and weak also. His father and mother are no more with him. And he lives with his grandmother. His grandmother told him that your father will bring lots of silver when he will return from his work, and your mother has also gone to Allah to get lovely gifts for you, which makes Hamid happy. The next paragraph. The moment Amina hears Hamid wants to go to the Eidgah, she becomes sad. Other boys are going out with their fathers. She is the only father Hamid has. How can she let him go to the fair all by himself? What if he lost in the crowd? No, she must not lose her precious little soul. The fair is about 3 miles from their house. How can he walk 3 miles? He doesn't even have a pair of shoes. He will get blisters on his feet. If she went along with him, she could pick him up now and then, but then who would be there to kick the semiya when he comes back? She almost burst into tears when he leaves with others. So, as Hamid is very excited to go to the Eidgah, but Grandma is so much worried because she can't allow him to go alone with others because she loves him very much. She's also worried that Eidgah is 3 miles away and he don't have pair of shoes, so how can he go barefoot? And if she goes with the child, then who will be there to cook seviya when Hamid will come back? So all these things makes her worried and she burst into tears. This shows her love for her grandchild. The villagers leave for the fair in a group. With the boys is Hamid. So finally, Grandma allows Hamid to go with the other villagers. The boys run on ahead of the elders and wait for them under a tree. When they reach the suburbs of the town, it begins to get crowded. Groups heading for the Eidgah are coming into town from different sides, each one dressed better than the other. So here we can see that the boys are too excited. They are running ahead of the elders and are waiting for them under a tree. When they reach the suburbs, that is a residential area, so it begins to get crowded. People from different villages, from different sides are gathering there to go to the Eidgah. And each group of people is dressed better than the others. Some come on tongas and ekas, some in motor cars, all wearing perfume, all bursting with excitement. Everybody is very much excited to go to the Eidgah. Our small party of village rustics is not bothered about the poor show they make. They are a calm, contented lot. So now here it is told that the village people, they are unsophisticated villagers. They are very simple people. They don't know how to make a show. So that is why they do not bother about what others are wearing, on what vehicle others are coming. They are calm. They are calm people, and contented means they are satisfied with what they have. Now coming to the next page, we see the paragraph, for village children, everything in the town is strange. They stand and gape at everything with wonder. Hamid is nearly run over by a car. Finally, the Eidgah comes in view. The boys flock towards the street and toy vendors' stores. And then there is the roundabout strung with wooden elephants, horses and camels. Now, finally, all the villagers along with the children, they have reached Eidgah. They have reached the fair. And the children are looking into the things strangely. They stand and gape at everything. Gape is to look at something with your open mouth. They are very much surprised with whatever they see there. Hamid is nearly run over by a car. Finally, the Eidgah comes in view. The boys flock here means flock of boys. And flock, you all know, flock is a collection of something. So here, flock means, if I say in Hindi, it is jhund. Okay. So the flock of boys towards the sweet and toy vendor stores. So the boys ran together towards the stores of sweets and toys. And then there is the roundabout strung with wooden elephants, horses and camels. And now there are rounds of wooden elephants, horses and camels. I think all of you have seen these swings in the fairs. You might have seen. Pay 1 paisa and have 25 rounds of fun. So it cost 25 rounds cost just 1 paisa. His friends Mahmood, Mossi, Nure and other boys mount the horses and camels. They took the 25 rounds. But Hamid watches them from a distance. He has not taken that 25 rounds. He missed that fun. All he has are 3 paisas because he only has 3 paisas with him. He can't afford to part with a third of his treasure for a few miserable rounds. And he was not ready to pay 1 paisa just for these miserable rounds. As in the starting I have told you, he was looking for something special. He wanted to buy something unique. They finish with the roundabouts and line up for the toys. Now the boys are heading towards the toys. Mahmood buys a policeman in khaki with a red turban on his head and a gun on his shoulder. Mohsin likes the water carrier with his back bent under the weight of the water bag. Noore has fallen for the lawyer. Again, Hamid looks at them with a desire to hold each one of them. Again, he has not bought any toy also. He was just gazing at the toys and he just wanted to hold them because he is also a child. He also wishes to have all the toys like any other child. They cost 2 paisa each. He thinks for a moment if he really wants them. So he just started thinking, do I really want them? Shall I spend my money on these miserable toys? No. If they dropped out of his hand, they would be smashed to bits. They would be broken into pieces because they are made up of, they are wooden toys. If a drop of water fell on them, the paint would run. So they are of no use to him. Finally, he gets himself satisfied with these things. But still his eyes look at them hungrily and he wishes he could hold them in his hands for just a moment or two. Still he wishes to hold them and still he wishes to have them. After the toys come the sweets, sesame seed, candies, gulab jamuns and halwa. They smack their lips with relish. So all the boys, they have taken all the sweets, they have taken their good taste and their lips were smacking with their taste, with their awesome taste. Only Hamid is left out. So he was left for all the things. Next to the sweet vendors, there were a few hardware stores. All the children go ahead. All of them except Hamid. Now the children move to some next door. But again, Hamid stood there. Who stops to see a pile of tongs? It occurs to him that his granny doesn't have a pair of tongs. So when he saw a pile of tongs, it came to his mind that his granny doesn't have this. Each time she bakes chapatis, the hot iron pan burns her fingers. If he were to buy her a pair of tongs, she would never burn her fingers. It would be a useful thing to have in the house. So what he is thinking, every time her grandmother makes chapatis, hot iron pan burn her fingers. So he wishes, he thought that it would be a useful thing to have in the house.